The Philippines is highly vulnerable to the impacts of climate change, including sea level rise, increased frequency of extreme weather events, rising temperatures and extreme rainfall. This is due to its high exposure to natural hazards, cyclones, landslides, floods, droughts, dependence on climate-sensitive natural resources and vast coastlines where all major cities and the majority of the population reside. The Philippines lies in the world's most cyclone-prone region, averaging 19 to 20 cyclones each year, of which 7 to 9 make landfall. Sea levels in the Philippines are rising faster than the global average, increasing the hazard posed by storm surges and threatening permanent inundation of low-lying areas. A rich yet increasingly depleted natural and marine resources base supports livelihoods through fisheries, agriculture, forestry, energy, mining and tourism and provides critical ecosystem services such as shoreline protection, flood control, soil stability and habitats for biodiversity. Climate risk profile, Philippines. More of this. Days of heavy rains brought by Typhoon Vamco and the monsoon-inundated Cagayan Valley in the northern Philippines have turned parts of the region into an ocean, officials said on Saturday. At least 37 people have died, with 22 injured and 15 others missing after Typhoon Vamco, local name Ulysses, cut a swath through the main island of Luzon on Friday. The National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council, NDRRMC, said. Flooding turns towns, cities in Philippines into ocean. Manila, home to 14 million people, is both subsiding due groundwater extraction and suffering from sea level rise. Neighboring Indonesia is moving its seat of government out of Jakarta in part due to similar circumstances. Sea level rise projection map, Manila, Earth. Org, past, present, future. 30% of Philippine caloric intake comes from seafood. A substantial subset of that is from shellfish. Oceanic acidification due to increased uptake of carbon dioxide, which then binds with oceanic calcium to form carbonic acid, is weakening shellfish shells, in much the same way DDT weakened bird egg shells in the mid-20th century. On top of that, algal blooms and marine biotoxins are increasing. Shellfish are a critical part of the oceanic food chain, so 10% to 30% of the Philippine food supply is threatened.